He is the father of a young woman and her brothers and sisters. And he's an autocrat, and they're poor, and it's a very harsh existence. And it's the story of her coming alive after being emotionally buried alive by this guy. When something happens, she's finally liberated and is able to actually move forward in her life. I think the modern audience will recognise all of it. They'll recognise a woman's struggle. They'll recognise a parent, hopefully not their own parent, but they'll know of parents who give no... there's no room for anyone else to move. They will live, it's his way or the highway. You know, and I think they'll recognise that when you live in that oppressive environment, what it is to try and survive it, I think they'll get it.
You're working with an astonishing director in Terence. What is unique about him as a force behind the camera?
He's a poet. He's got a wonderful, earthy lyricism about him, and he's got a lovely personality, and it comes across in his movies.
Obviously Agyness as well, a luminous talent in the film. What was your experience like working with her?
Well, it's strange because most of the time my character doesn't look at her, so I don't know what she's like. She's a lovely lady, but I never looked at her in the whole film, so I'm going to go and find out.